Hello, and welcome to St. Louis University. My name is Anne, and I am a senior admission counselor in St. Louis University's Office of Admission. As a two-time alum of St. Louis University, I love chatting about SLU, which we're going to do for the next time period. If you've ever seen our mascot, our sports play, you've probably asked yourself the question, what in the world is a Billiken? And if you've never heard the story behind it, back around the World's Fair here in the local area, a local artist drew this up and she wanted it to symbolize things as they ought to be. Quickly became a fad. It was put on belt buckles and piggy banks and got traded. Had nothing to do with St. Louis University until local sports writers thought that John Bender, our football coach at the time period, looked like this made-up creature. He had pointy ears, rounder face, little tufts of hair on the top of his head. You all can decide if that is a nice compliment or not, though he quickly became known as Bender's Billikens. The football team did not stick with us, however, the name did. So for over 100 years now, we have been known as the St. Louis University Billikens. You're going to find that there is a statue on campus. Students will rub the stomach of it. Students will trade Billikens and take them with them when they study abroad. But when you ask a student what a Billiken is, they really go back to the fact that it's a unique mascot. We are the only Billikens in the entire world. And that symbol of making the world as it ought to be, students really grasp onto and really challenge themselves to go out into the world and make it as they see as it ought to be. Part of our identity is a Catholic Jesuit institution. And if you're not familiar with that Jesuit education, it's an order within the Catholic Church, St. Ignatius of Loyola, founded in the mid-1500s. What that means now, however, day in and day out, is that we believe our students are educated holistically. So we talk about the whole person, or the mind, body, as well as the spirit. In that education as a whole person, we are going to care for you as a whole person, cura personalis, or care of the whole. So as you are growing as a person, we are going to care for you as a whole person. You are also going to be educated inside and outside of the classroom space. So through your interactions, like a study abroad experience, like an internship, or another practical experience, you are going to grow as a person through all of your opportunities across SLU's campus. Another part of who we are as a Jesuit school is that concept and commitment to service. And our students will say persons for and with others. So really considering how we make a difference in the world. I love how one of our Jesuits on our campus phrases it. He says, we are here not just to serve in the soup kitchens, rather we are here to shut the soup kitchens down. So understanding what the root issue is and making a difference that way. Here at SLU, our academics as a Jesuit university is going to be rigorous. We're going to challenge you. And as we challenge you, we're also going to support you. You are going to grow in ways you might not even see yet. As you develop skills, knowledge, and values that you are going to make and use to make an impact on the world. One metric or way that we really track how successful our students are is that retention rate. If you've never seen a retention rate before, you can think about it as persistence, or it's the amount of students that return or persist for that following year. So this is our current freshman or first year retention rate for SLU, and then national averages for four-year public institutions as well as four-year private institutions. Another metric that we measure on the back end is graduation rates. So here are our current four-year and six-year graduation rates. Once again, national averages for four-year public schools as well as four-year private schools. So we think we do this pretty well. As a Jesuit university, part of our process of growth is that focus on reflection. Some individuals might refer to it as discernment, and it's really the consideration of asking yourself the questions, who am I? What do I value? Who do I want to be friends with? How do I spend my time? And for students on this campus, it could be done in informal ways as well as formal ways. informally, it could be you having a conversation with a fellow SLU student who comes from a very different background than yourself, and that'll start to prompt some thought and reflection. In formal ways, it's integrated into classwork, into your experience being a student worker on campus, as well as your interactions with faculty and staff. So whether you recognize it or not, reflection will be integrated throughout your 4 years on SLU's campus. Students also have a wide variety of opportunities to take what you're learning in a classroom space and apply it in some way, shape, or form. So if we're going to go through the 7 colleges and schools that our undergraduate students are a part of, we're going to start off with that School of Education. Our School of Education students are in a classroom setting almost every single semester on SLU's campus. So you are going to be here in the local area, private schools, public schools, charter schools, working with the current students and growing in your teaching abilities, culminating in a student teaching experience your senior year. If you're in our College for Public Health and Social Justice, that emphasis could be on working with nonprofits, volunteering, having clinical opportunities, internship routes. If you're in our Doisy College of Health Sciences, clinical rotations, there are over 500 clinical sites. It could also be an internship or working in the state-of-the-art labs that we have within the college. Our School of Nursing students have the opportunity to work with our Clinical Simulation Center, which is essentially robots that simulate things like a birth before you actually start to get to those clinical rotations in various hospital settings throughout the city. If students are in our Parks College of Engineering, Aviation, and Technology, if you're on the engineering side, there's a lot of hands-on works within lab spaces. There's an opportunity, if you'd like to, for a co-op or an internship. Research. If our students are on the flight science side, we have these awesome flight simulators before you actually work with our own fleet of airplanes. If you're in our Richard A. Chaffetz School of Business, internships, there are 9 Fortune 500 companies headquartered here in St. Louis, and we're also known as a great startup city, so that you can work with one of those companies. And if you're in our College of Arts and Sciences, there are so many different opportunities, all dependent upon your area. So if you are in neuroscience or biology, pre-medicine, pre-PA, pre-veterinary track, research opportunities, working with the materials in lab spaces. Our theater students are doing shows during a year. Our studio art students are working with the materials. Political science, sociology, psychology could be researchers, could also be working in internships. There are so many different ways our SLU students are taking what they're learning in a classroom space and applying it in some way, shape, or form. As you are learning and growing as a person, we are supporting you in your academic arena as well as your career arena. So when we consider your academic arena, the first thing that you are going to have is an academic advisor. This is a professional staff member who has a master's degree that is there to help support you through your 4 years of learning. They are individuals that will help you and help plan out your schedule of study abroad experiences, and they are more than a scheduler. They are there to help you grow as a person and develop ownership of the fact that this is your education. You will have choices on SLU's campus. You might decide between a Monday, Wednesday, Friday class or a Tuesday, Thursday class. You know yourself best, and so they're going to be there for you to help build that ownership, as well as connect you to resources that you may or may not know that you need. So being that first layer of support. We also have tutoring and supplemental instruction, and that's a great opportunity to work with a peer and helping reiterate going over some of the content knowledge that you're learning. We have writing services that will work with you on any formal writing, whether that's a paper, a thesis project. We have academic coaching and our academic technology commons, all there for your arena and support in your academic growth. On the career side, we have faculty mentors. Your faculty mentor is a faculty member on SLU's campus that's related to your specific discipline. They're going to work with you and connect you to potential research opportunities, to the opportunities of professional development starting that first year on SLU's campus. And we have career counselors. Career counselors can help you develop your future career or help you along the pathway to that future career. They host career and internships fairs. They host career expo nights so that you can lay out and work through their four-year professional development plan so that you are successful post-graduation in finding that job, that graduate school, that professional school. So all areas that help support you in your mind. However, when we think about that mind, there are other layers of support for you. In that mind, that body, and that spirit, one other way is university counseling. When it comes to university counseling, you are offered 10 free sessions in an academic year. So that just means you can go and talk to someone. Transition to college, and college is going to be tough. You might encounter challenges that you have never encountered in your life before. And we are going to be there to support you and have another person that you can go to and chat with. Campus ministry can also support you in your mind and your spirit as well. They have so many different opportunities, whether that is a spiritual director or guidance, faith sharing groups, Bible study groups, masses and retreats, all for your spiritual as well as that mind wellness component. And when it comes to your body, there is a likelihood that you may get sick on a college campus. So we have our student health center. And our student health center has not only a health center, it also has a physical therapy center as well. When it comes to the student health center, there is always nurses as well as a doctor, and then specialties rotate through. And they're open in a traditional 8:30 to 5. We also know, however, that your health doesn't stop between that time period. So if something happens later on at night, you can call their hotline, chat with a nurse, and that individual can help direct you if you should make an appointment with them tomorrow, if you should go to urgent care or the hospital. If for some reason you need physical therapy, there is a center on SLU's campus. When I was an undergrad, I actually used that when I tore my ACL. So it is something where a faculty member of the physical therapy program might actually be your physical therapist in that. Both are located, the health center and that physical therapy area, on SLU's campus. And then when we think about your other forms of wellness, we want to make sure that you're taking care of your body. So part of that is going to be maybe you working out in our Simon Recreation Center. That Simon Recreation Center has a 3/4 mile track, 6 different basketball areas, which can also be converted into volleyballs or badminton courts. There's also equipment in there for you to utilize and take care of yourself. In the campus recreation, they also have wellness programming centered around all of the different topics that students encounter when coming to a college or university. And there's a lot of peer-to-peer relationships that happen within that wellness education. So your mind, your body, and your spirit is taken care of as we care for you. The question you might be asking yourself is, okay, Anne, awesome. What is my first year going to look like? And we have many different opportunities there for you. SLU 101 is that first step. It's summer orientation. We have fall welcome, which would be during your move-in time period. If you might be a commuter student, we have a first-year commuter program where you will have access to the commuter lounge. You also will have a commuter assistant, and you can check out a locker for the day if you need to store things. University 101 is a very unique experience for us, where it's an introductory 1-credit-hour course, and it is co-taught by either a faculty or staff member along with a current student. So those two individuals together lay out the curriculum and co-teach you in that transition to college. It's a great 1-hour credit course for our first-year students. And there's also a residential experience. When it comes to living on campus, about 92 to 93% of our first and second year students are living on campus. The other 7 to 8% of students are living in the local area and commuting to St. Louis University. There's a lot of different opportunities when it comes to living on campus, and you can see some of those benefits listed out. Learning communities are one really unique opportunity, and on SLU's campus, we currently have 8 different living learning communities. Some of them are centered around academic areas, while others are centered around value pieces. So if you're interested and have applied to the honors program, or if you are an engineering student, a business student, a health sciences student, one of those living learning communities might be a fit for you. If you are interested in service and faith, the MICA program could also be a fit for you. All of our living learning communities are listed out on SLU's website, and it dives into a little bit about all of those integration of pieces that would be there for you in those living learning communities. You would take classes together, have some form of community nights. All of that, though, would be different between each of the living learning communities. About 50% of our first-year students are in a living learning community, about 50% are not. So there's different opportunities dependent upon what the fit is for you as a student. Let's revisit where you might potentially live on SLU's campus. This map outlines all of our first and second-year residence halls, which are circled in white. So we're going to start at the bottom of the screen. There is Reinert Hall, and that is a converted hotel. In there, square footage is a little bit larger, so you're going to be sharing with 2 other people, and your bathroom is in your room. If you are living in Grand or Spring Hall, those are great opportunities for suite style. So it might be you in your own bedroom space and a shared bathroom space with one other person, or it might be 2 people in a bedroom space, another 2 people but in a bedroom space, a half bath and a half bath. Grisedeck Hall or complex area is community style. So you would be sharing a bathroom space with everyone else on your floor, and you would have a sink in your room with 2 individuals in that room. Marguerite Hall is a Jack and Jill style. So you would walk into your room, and a bathroom at the back of your room is what would connect those 4 individuals, 2 in each room, together. If you are a visual learner, I would encourage you to go onto SLU's website. It does outline the actual square footages as well as what is included in each of the rooms. When it comes to junior and senior year, you would be able to stay on campus if you would like to, and those are the blue circles on this map are upperclassmen apartment complexes. And if you'd like to move off campus, you have that ability to do so. When I talk about off campus, though, I make a joke that our students that move off campus are resimuters, because typically they're moving across the street from SLU's campus. On most of the perimeters of SLU's campus are privately owned apartment complexes, high percentages of SLU students. So you walk across the street to get to campus rather than potentially get in a car and drive to campus. You will also need to eat on campus, and our dining facilities have a couple of different options within it. Our grand dining hall has 9 different action stations, and this is the one main dining hall on SLU's campus. And you will always find something a fit for you. Having 9 different action stations, there is hot food, there's salad, there's ice cream. So how you'd like to eat every day. Now, I wouldn't necessarily recommend ice cream every meal, and those opportunities will be there within that grand dining hall. There's also a grab-and-go style, so you have the opportunity to take it more like a food court or grab-and-go. Those are both included on SLU's campus, and those tend to be more of the national brands. So you might find the Starbucks on SLU's campus or the St. Louis Bread Co. For those of you that aren't in the St. Louis area, you probably know St. Louis Bread Co. as Panera, and in St. Louis, it's St. Louis Bread Company. Pro tip for you. If you have dietary restrictions, you also have those opportunities to meet with someone within the dining services so that you can walk through where you're going to eat. If you have allergies, gluten-free, they'll help support you along the way. You are going to have so many opportunities as a SLU student to get involved and engaged, and there are a plethora of ways. Having over 150 different student organizations on SLU's campus means that you are going to find your niche. Whether that's bringing student speakers to campus or national speakers, having a concert, being the voice to administration for the students, there are a lot of opportunities. I recently went and saw Abby Wambach. She came through our Great Issues Committee in connection with our athletics department. Very cool experience. I've also seen Bill Nye the Science Guy. I grew up with Bill Nye the Science Guy and loved being able to see him in person. If you are interested in intramural or club sports, let's start with the fact that we do have 18 different Division I sports. So you might actually be the ones cheering on, or you are a student athlete. There are 32 club sports on SLU's campus that range in competitive levels. Some of them you try out, you travel, you compete. Some of them are a little less competitive. And then you have intramural sports where you are playing with your fellow SLU students. Maybe some bragging rights and a t-shirt. The global experience is also important. We have our own campus in Madrid, Spain. And some students are spending 4 years over there or 2 years in Madrid, Spain. Other students are looking for a one-semester or two-semester study abroad experience. And in our study abroad locations, we have a pre-approved location on every continent, except Antarctica. I'm sorry about that one. So students can go to Madrid, Spain, Galway, Ireland, Cape Town, South Africa, South Korea. There are so many different ways to go and experience the world. We do have Greek life on campus. There are different opportunities to engage in that sisterhood or that brotherhood. There are 25 in total across the university and in the city of St. Louis. With those opportunities, we do not have houses. However, you still can get engaged and involved through that sisterhood or that brotherhood. Diversity and social justice, community service and engagement are so integrated throughout SLU's campus into a different student organization or through a service learning class. It's part of our identity that we embrace as a university. So students, you are going to have so many different ways to get involved and engaged on SLU's campus. That engagement is also going to expand to the city of St. Louis. Our students view the St. Louis area as our home in addition. When I came to the city of St. Louis, I quickly discovered that it is a city of neighborhoods, and there are so many different neighborhoods, and each neighborhood has a different personality and style. And in that, I quickly realized that you can eat your way through the city of St. Louis. Even the Chicago Tribune gives a shout out to the city of St. Louis and all of the great food that we have. To highlight the main corridor that SLU sits within, we are in Midtown area, and that's classified as the Arts District in St. Louis. There are radio stations and museums within a walkable distance. Fox Theater, which is where shows come through, as well as Powell Hall, which is where the St. Louis Symphony plays, are within walkable distances as well. If students are headed downtown, they might be seeing the Cardinals or the Blues playing, maybe the MLS team going up in the arch, soaking up the sun on the beautiful arch grounds, all to get a better sense of the city of St. Louis. If our students are going back the other way, they're hitting the Central West End. It is where the Basilica is located. There are food opportunities, boutique stores, half-priced bookstores, all located in the Central West End. And just beyond that is my favorite place in St. Louis, beyond all the great food, of course, is Forest Park. Forest Park is the largest urban park in the United States. It's almost 2 times the size of Central Park in New York City, and there are over 15 miles of hiking, biking trails, and associate the word free with Forest Park. There is a free zoo, a free art museum, a free history museum, a free science center. So much to do on a college budget. You will also notice at some point that there's redevelopment happening here in the area. There is the City Foundry, the Armory, the Steel Coat Lofts, all opening in the next couple of years. The City Foundry, which I am personally excited for, contains a lot of great food. Who doesn't love to eat? It's going to have different food stations within it. There will also be dining, event spaces, shops, a theater. And that is going to start opening this summer, July of 2020. So you have just heard some fantastic things about St. Louis University, how we're going to support you in your time at SLU, and what that first year might look a little bit like on campus. You're probably wondering to yourself, how do you become that Billiken? So seniors, let's walk through what those steps may look like for you. To start with, you're going to want to log into your MySLU account. Make sure you start to check your SLU email. You will actually already see emails in there. From there, once you log in, you will want to hit the Tools tab, and that is where you are going to submit your housing and tuition or enrollment deposit. It's both of those pieces together. You will wait 24, 48 hours for that information to be processed, and then you'll apply for housing via your housing contract, as well as register for SLU 101, which is our summer orientation. To give you a visual sense, here is what the MySLU account would look like once you've hit the Tools tab. We love our icons here. I want you to know that we have been planning and are so ready for you to come. We start planning for you in September, and we've been planning for almost a year now and can't wait for you to be on SLU's campus. One of the first ways that we've been planning for months is through our summer orientation, or SLU 101, as we call it. It is a two-day overnight experience that occurs in the month of June. The entire month of June, as our director of orientation would say, the party's rocking on SLU's campus every Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, Friday. You would choose one Monday, Tuesday, or Thursday, Friday session and come. Students, you would stay overnight. You'd get to know other members of your class, meet with an academic advisor, and schedule your classes for the fall semester. You also learn a lot about the resources on SLU's campus. The important thing is that during summer orientation, we have a student track and we have a parent and family track. We know that it's a transition for not only our students, also for parent and family members. And so we are very intentional about how we design that program, making meal points the touch times to check in, see how one another is doing. Once you've been through that summer orientation, you are going to be so excited to come back for that fall welcome. It's going to be an August move-in, and there are activities and events planned for our students. During this time period, you are readjusting again to SLU as my home for the next 4 years. So considering and walking through where your classes might be, who are my faculty members again? Let's check in with my academic advisor. All intentionality during that transition and actual physical move-in. There are parent and family events, and we have new student convocation. And those peers who are going to be there for you, I'll call our Oriflam leaders. Oriflam are going to be in those bright orange shirts, and not only do they help physically move your things into your residence hall, they also are going to be there to get you excited for a square dance and to have a lot of fun during orientation and to be a peer that you know on SLU's campus that can be a resource for you. So I hope you got to see a little bit about how you could potentially find your fit for the next 4 years on SLU's campus. And I want to bring it back to where we started. We started by talking about the Billiken and the symbol of making the world as it ought to be. Whether your choice is St. Louis University or elsewhere, we encourage you to think about how you're going to embody that Billiken no matter where you go. How are you going to go out and change the world and make it as it ought to be?